Necessary tools to remain champion?
I might bring a couple of things out. You know, I might go to the body a little bit, do a little body work. I wouldn't mind taking a fight out to the body because I got real nice skills with the body, you know, and it haven't fully came out yet. I got so many things that I'm capable of doing that I haven't really had to do yet. You know, I only measure my fighter, what he brings to the table, his style, and I go from there. I don't create nothing that I don't have to create. I want it as easy as it can be, you know. And that's what I do. So
it's no secret that both of you can punch. We're gonna see fireworks. I believe only one of your fights gone the distance. Correct.
Correct.
Will we see a distant fight or a knockout?
You know me. When I get in the ring, I'm looking to literally knock your head off your shoulder. You know, I want to see one. No, I don't want to see that. That's gonna be a blood mess. But I definitely want to hurt you. And even before I was champion, I was putting guys in the hospital. I was breaking bones. I was breaking different things on their body part. But as I became a champion, only one guy out of all my fights have not seen the hospital. Most of the guys I fought have visited the hospital and got admitted into the hospital. So they claimed the bed in the hospital. You know, and that's what type of fighter I am. You fight me, you gonna get put in the hospital. That's what's it, because that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to hurt you just enough. Like I told Cabern, I'm gonna beat you to a 1% of your life. And I think I did that because he had a lot of heads on one head.
Did you take offense to anything Chris said and Henry said about you before? I know he even said he talked a lot of crap about you before. Changed now, but.
I don't take no offense to nobody. I just had a guy from TMZ tell me about what Fury was talking about, how he was using sexual slurs, and he was really showing his true colors of you know, him coming out the closet. You know, he was coming out the closet. He was, you know, and ain't nothing wrong with coming out the closet. You know, I don't have no problem with nobody that liking the same gender, you know, and I think that what he's trying to say without really saying, just using that boxing term, that he wanted to have sex with me, and no thank you, Fury, you know. Yeah, but I don't take no offense to nothing. It's part of the business. It's part of promoting a fight. It just comes with the territory. And with that being said, I don't let no guy knock me off my focus point. I want you just to be about what you say when that time comes, and don't let just be a talk for the fans or media and stuff like that. Really mean what you say. And if you do that, when we do meet, I want you to carry that in that ring with me so we can make it a extravagant fight and a fight to remember for years and years when we gone.
You had to get the gas.
Did he get lucky when he fought Klitschko at that point of Klitschko's career? Because you were fighting everybody in their prime.
I wouldn't say he got lucky. I don't believe in luck, man. I believe either you're going to do it or you're not. And but with that Klitschko fight, I just think that he did enough to get in the Klitschko head like he did to talk and to have an awkward style on Klitschko. Because Klitschko used to fight smaller guys. He wanted to clinch and lean and do his just regular, I think, called bad habit for me, things. Because Manuel Stewart didn't teach him that, you know. And he knows that. But he's getting older. He got a family now. I'm sure he, you know, he had agreement and disagreement with family going on with spouse and stuff, and that takes a lot out of your career because it's been many a time, even with my spouse, we done had arguments the night of the fight. I'm like, man, I'm finna fight. You gonna
How do you
really
go in the ring like that?
That's just another thing, you know. When we do that, because it didn't happen more than one time, and I hate it. And women know when a man hates something, she'll still do it. But, you know, I just take it as an exercise to mentally block that out and stuff like that. And it works. So, you know, I can be mad before I even go in the ring. And then when I get in the ring, it's just like everything just calms back down, man.
Guys, we got to go. I'm sorry.
Sorry, guys. We got to go. Bob Squad!
I'll take
it
over.
Thank you, Deontay.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. So you've been good, though?
With Malik.
Malik? What do you think about Malik Scott?
That's my brother, man, for life.
He's a great dude.
Yeah, he is.
So last word, I gotta ask you this. Mayweather might fight McGregor. How would you do against, let's say, Brock Lesnar?
I'd love to fight Brock Lesnar, man.
What would happen in that fight?
I'd slam him.
Deontay, let's go.
All right, tell me about Malik Scott really quick. He's looking to fight David Haye. David Haye's ducking him. He's looking to fight all these guys. They're ducking him.
A lot of people ducking Malik Scott, man. You know, he didn't reevaluate himself. He recreated himself.
He's ready, man.
He's ready, and a lot of people see that he's ready. And they don't want to face that.
Look what you got
shirt,
Ellie.
They don't want to face that. This is my brother for life, man.
Malik Scott got me the shirt really quick.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, snap!
You know, so even y'all trying to get to me, y'all got to go through him first.
Woo, Ric Flair.
BB, I got you, B.
See you Monday.
Okay, I'll see you Monday. Dress warm. Just dress naked, man, because it's hot. It's hot down there. What's going on, man?
Take a picture with me.
Yeah, no problem.
Take a picture with me.
You know, he knocked out Lucien Boutte with a 30-second count. They're still counting. Hold on.
Boutte just got called for.
Yeah, he
got it.
He was doing it. Now he was
doing it. Doing it again, huh? Still not coming out.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.